بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful, may Allah's peace and blessings be upon the soul of our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. The respected viewers, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to another episode, and today is so special because we will talk about the day of Eid. Eid is the chance and opportunity for happiness. Happiness that's well-deserved. Happiness that's based upon ta'ah, that comes after obedience of Allah, that comes after iman and faith demonstration for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first Eid comes after Ramadan and fasting, and a beautiful opportunity for all Muslims to show their faith and iman to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they complete the month of Ramadan, then celebrate Eid al-Fitr. This Eid is Eid al-Adha. Pilgrims show and demonstrate the iman and faith and submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by leaving their home countries and hometowns behind, and their own families and their own businesses and everything, the whole dunya, they leave behind and they go to do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded them to do. Remembering Allah and mentioning the name of Allah, making tawaf to remember Allah, making sa'i to remember Allah, sacrificing and offer the sacrifices for Allah. The body is suffering, however, the soul is flourishing and getting more and more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And everybody around the world, during those 10 days, they do special things, being it sadaqah or fasting or silatul rahim or qira'atul Qur'an or any good deed. And then at the end, we do the udhiyah, we do the sacrifice, like Ibrahim alayhi salam, who was offered the ransom for his son after he listened to Allah Azza wa Jalla and obeyed Allah in this very tough command that came to him to slaughter and sacrifice his own son for the sake of Allah, and he did not hesitate. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala offered him the ransom, and Allah made all the believers throughout the history to follow in his footsteps and offer something for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he even made a Eid of Al-Adha, the Eid of Qurbani and sacrifice for the sake of Allah, to remember that ta'ah and sacrifice for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that submission, that highest level of submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After we do this, we celebrate the day of Eid. وَلِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ جَعَلْنَا مَنْسَكًا لِيَذْكُرُ اسْمَ اللَّهِ. For every ummah, there is the ritual. Allah made the ritual for them to remember Allah. Our Eid is ta'ah and comes after ta'ah, is obedience for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and happiness because of what we fulfilled and what we achieved, the milestones that we achieve, another year of ta'atullahi tabaraka wa ta'ala, another opportunity of showing our submission and our faith to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then we celebrate, then we become happy, then we announce for the whole world, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Everybody, not only the pilgrims, announce this beautiful nida and call, proclaim that Allah is the greatest. Allah is the greatest of all. Allah Azza wa Jalla and the command of Allah is the greatest. We say it and we announce it and we implement it in our life in the day of Al-Eid. Days of Eid are days of Dhikrullah, continuation of Dhikrullah in a different form. No fasting, it is haram to fast on the day of Al-Eid. Ayyamu Al-Eid, ayyamu aklin wa shurbin wa dhikrullahi ta'ala. As the Prophet ﷺ said, the days of Eid, Eid al-Adha, and Eid al-Fitr as well, but more so of Eid al-Adha because it's followed by another 3 days of At-Tashriq that people are supposed to, these are days of eating, drinking, and remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For the pilgrims in Mecca, the day of An-Nahr, the day of Eid, the 10th of Dhul Hijjah, is the best because it involves most of the actions or the top actions of Hajj. They occur and they take place in this day, the day of Al-Eid, because there is Tawaful Ifadah. They, on this night, the night before, they move from Muzdalifah to Mina, And then on the day of Al-Adha, they go to the Al-Ka'bah to make Tawaf Al-Ifadah and Sa'i between Al-Safa and Marwa, and then they come back for Jamrat Al-Aqabah Al-Kubra. They throw the biggest Jamra on that day. They also make the Halq before that, and they get the Udhiyah or the sacrifice or the Hadi being slaughtered on their behalf or being offered on their behalf. So this day, Eid al-Adha, is so special for everybody, whether the pilgrims or those who are not making Hajj. It is a day of farha, it is a day of happiness, it is a day of showing that this is our day. This day is chosen for us, and it is defined for us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the conclusion of those so special days of the beginning of the 10 days of the month of Dhul-Hijjah, the beginning of the month of Dhul-Hijjah that we talked about, how special they are, how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam highlighted their specialty and they are the best days ever, comes the day of Eid al-Adha to conclude our fasting for those who are fasting, to offer udhiyah for those who are capable of making udhiyah. And according to Imam Abu Hanifa, it's wajib. It's clear in the hadith of an-Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, من وجد ساعة فلم يضحي فلا يقربن مصلانا. Those who can afford to offer an udhiyah, to offer qurbani, to offer a sacrifice on the day of Eid, those who can afford and they did not do it, let them not come to our musalla. Let them not come to pray with us. What does this mean? Does it mean that the Prophet ﷺ is highly urging the Muslims to offer udhiyah and sacrifice if they can? Or it makes it obligatory, you have to make it. It is somewhere in between. So they make the udhiyah, Muslims make udhiyah, Muslims get together all over the world in this beautiful scene. Whether you are in Korea or Japan, Australia, New Zealand, from New Zealand, from the eastern part of the world to the western part of the world, throughout the world, Muslims come out in the nicest dress, in the nicest souls, in the nicest of attitudes, greeting one another, exchanging the greetings of peace, announcing, magnifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and announcing that there is nothing greater than Allah. Allah is the greatest. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd, praying the Eid prayer, rejoicing on that day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them to rejoice and to be happy, remembering Ibrahim alayhi salam and the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam and his family, Ismail, this beautiful prophet Ismail alayhi salam, Hajar alayhi salam, being great examples and role models for all believers to sacrifice for the sake of Allah, to let go, to put the will of Allah before your own will. Remembering Hajar alayhi salam, a mother, how could a mother do this? How could a mother afford to be left alone with her baby in the desert? How could a little boy accept to be slaughtered by his own father just because of a dream? Yes, I believe in you, father. Yes, you are a prophet, but why? This is the time that we put why aside, because yes, in Islam, the mind and the brain and the intellect is so important. However, we don't worship that. We use that as one of the creation of Allah. Allah is the one that we follow. Allah Azza wa Jalla is the one that we submit to. That was shown to us in action by Ibrahim alayhi salam and his son Ismail alayhi salam, two of the greatest prophets, and Hajar alayhi salam, and then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All of this we remember and we celebrate and we connect to on the day of Eid. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of our days Eids. This day is so special. Let's be happy on that day. Let's reconnect. I know there are things between us and other people. Things happen in this life, but these opportunities, Ramadans and Eids, they come to reconnect, to reconcile us. Let's reconcile. Let's get in touch with one another again, because we're all servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And unless we forgive one another, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not forgive us. Let's forgive one another. Let's get happy with the ta'a of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala together, coming out to musalla of al-Eid, to the day of Eid, inshaAllah, clean and pure and ready to accept the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we truly celebrate Eid. Thank you very much, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open the Kaaba for us and the house of Allah for us in the next years to go and make Hajj and celebrate Eid with the pilgrims in Mecca, inshaAllah. Barakallahu feekum. May Allah bless you all. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.